Welcome back to Particle Fleet Emergence, a preview, Shade of Dead style. I am Shade of Dead, and today we are going into, I guess, Mission 2, Indelible. We're supposed to destroy all enemy structures, the associates of Ticon Corporation, in a redacted space, and everything is as anticipated, or at least so it seems. Allow us to launch our mission. Jump complete. We have entered redacted space. Danu, sensor readings. There's a particulate threat here. We got two things here, looks like. Exactly like in Anna's simulations, but there are two emitters. Odd. There's substantial wreckage here, energy crystals, and what appears to be two tech modules. Toth? I like Toth. What do you make of these energy readings? There is spatial plasma in the region. Oh, I've seen these readings before. If my assessment is correct, the blue plasma in this region of space should slow the movement of any particles. I agree, but the plasma is unstable and is likely to decay upon contact with the particles. Very good. Kami, prepare engineering to receive those tech modules. We are going to retrieve them. Already on it. And Ogun, stand ready. You know it, Chief. He's the guy that likes to blow stuff up. Done. Okay, so here we are. We've got a technology. These are energy crystals. They are caches of instant energy. Meyer here with Omni. Okay. So this is still kind of tutorial. I guess first thing we need is a... our corporate headquarters. So we're going to warp it in. Press P to unpause. It's going to build that. And then I'm going to build some of these. Let's go ahead and get a lathe built. And I suppose we should build a destroyer too. Let's back up here. Let's put an Omni here. It says it wants it right there. I guess I can only build one Omni. So that's the one that's going to go there. All right, we're using these energy crystals to power things. Let's get up here. Let's get some more power. Let's get up here. You get up there. Yeah, like that. I'm gonna assume that's an Omni that I'm gonna get, but you can see how this stuff hits the blue. And then it slows down. Yeah. Alright, here we go. We got plenty of power at the moment. Additional lathe ship has been integrated into our Galcore license manager. The new lathe appears in the build panel left. I recommend immediate construction as it appears it will be needed. I'm going to have to agree with you. I think it will be needed as well. Let's get that. A license for another Omni. Okay, well that's fine. Let's get this other lathe built, and then we are going to make some journeying out into this space. I want to collect this energy orb thing, and then I can build an Omni here, because I just got another one. And, man, there is a lot. Oh, wow, they're all piling up on this thing. On that energy orb. Okay, so let's get up here. We're slowly miring. We're getting some energy. We're doing pretty good. I don't seem to be draining these power supplies. These extra energy supply things. Let's throw an Omni down. You can see the red particles are hitting this and turning it red. See, watch this guy. He's going to disappear. And then you saw a little block appear. This guy's going to come down here, hit. And he makes another block. So they can mire the land red while we are trying to turn it blue. So you can lose out on this battle, as it were. It doesn't seem to be getting through, but I'm going to go ahead and move this guy up here. He is not one I want to lose. He's not a ship I really want to lose at all. But... we gotta get up here closer. Oh, I might lose a lathe here in a minute. Ooh, that was close. There we go. Alright, so now I have access to some stuff. Let's go down here. I'm just kind of moving forward. We're going to have to try to push through. Now, there's red. This red stuff is just like the blue stuff, except it doesn't affect the particles. It affects my ship. So watch how he slows down. Look how slow he's going there. That's because of the red stuff. I got to get a little bit closer to be able to start destroying that. They're all going for the destroyer, which is fine, I guess. That's what it's for. And again, ships die. It's okay. Oh, they're still trying. They're about to destroy my energy thing. Oof. It's damaged. The particles totally damaged it. He's just getting free. Let's move forward with the destroyer. And I'm just kind of taking the damage. Now I'm going to show you something. We'll wait. But these ships are not... If I lose this ship, I'm not going to cry about it, because I can rebuild it. And there aren't people on these ships. These ships are unmanned. Techno licenses, energy crystals, dual particulate emitters. We didn't expect this much this close to the edge of redacted space. Other ships must have been destroyed this close to the boundary. In private, we came for answers, and I believe we will soon have them. Victory. All right, that wasn't terrible. I'll submit my time. Oh, name must not be empty. Oh, my name, as you know, Shade of Dead. Submit. There, I'm number 15. I'm so proud, but that's only because there's not very many people that have played it yet. So, whatever. I didn't rush it. That's not a very good time. There are people that are much better than me at this game, but let's exit. We're not going to stick around, and we're going to go to level 3. Destroy all enemy structures. Ticon Corporation begins to wonder if their preparation has been sufficient. Have we made a huge mistake? Let's find out. There was an instability in the jump out of the rift. I'll adjust. Perhaps the significant threats in this system have something to do with it. Steady, crew. Anna, what do you make of this system? Wreckage, like the previous system. Multiple particulate emitters, but the scale. The emitters here are stronger, and I believe they will emit particulate that are bound together. Bound particulate? Does your simulation predict this? Yes, but I thought we would not encounter it until we were much further into redacted space. I need to run some calculations, I just need to run some calculations first. Okay, alright. Crew, there's wreckage here. We should collect as well as an info cache. Perhaps that will contain logs of a long-lost corporate headquarters. And perhaps that will be useful for our own survival. Prepare all systems to engage and eliminate threats here and get me that info cache. Alright. We're going to slam this bad boy down right here so we can build both of those. Let's get a lathe build. Let's build one. Now let's throw an Omni down right there. And the destroyer, let's build it just in case. And let's go. Oh, there is an emitter right here. Ooh. And things, they are connected. Look, it's a snake. Wacky arm flailing inflatable tube man. Wacky arm flailing inflatable tube man. All right. So I've got those. Let's go get whatever this is. I think that's a ship schematic. There's the info cache, I think. Use Omnis to defeat the emitter. Yes, I know. And there's another Omni, it would appear. There we go. Let's go ahead and build the other lathe. We're going to be low on power here very soon. Interesting, I've never seen this ship design. It isn't currently available in the Galcor inventories. I've integrated the license and it has activated, though. A hidden design? Very odd. You see that? There is both a particle beam and a missile launcher on this guy. Plus two engines. Talk about a rapid response ship. Is it just me or can anyone else sense Ogun's excitement? The particle beam should slow down particulate. This will be useful. I can also modulate it to repair decayed blue plasma and remove red plasma. Both should assist us with... assist us with some particulate devastation. Everyone get ready to watch some missiles chase down some particulate. He gets really way more excited than he probably should. That's just me. Let's get down here and work on cleaning this up. I think that's going to be my best choice here of action at the moment. And then once I get this built, see how this is starting to turn gray? That's because it's wearing it away. And this stuff's going to start really flying through there. All right, get in here. Get down here. See, and then he's got this little laser, the blue square, and it fixes it. It repairs it. So let's get down here and let's destroy this emitter quickly. Oh, incoming. Back up, back up, back up. Destroy it. All right, there we go. And then you get down here and you get down here. Now, we're outside of the range of the energy. The lathes seem to work even when you are outside the energy, but the weapons will wear out eventually. And as well as the speed of the... The speed of the ship. All right, we got another Omni. As soon as this guy gets done. You know what, we'll build another one up here just to make this part faster. We're going to claim this energy field. We've got that. This guy is sitting here going to mire all this land. I really need to get an Omni on that right away, actually. You come down here. Get on that. And then you three, let's head up here. And you may as well come with. And we'll get this info cache. And try to hold all this back while work is being done here to get me more power. Because this will give me more energy and make my life just easier. This guy is going to destroy the red. This red stuff that slows me down and makes me move slow. So clearing that out of my way might be a good idea. The info cache is unencrypted but only partially preserved. It is very old and uses a version of data compression that is, well, ancient. But I think I can access some of the data. WinZip. All there. Most of the data is telemetry and a mess, but there is one entry from a personal log. Data follows. Chairman Ragnall's personal log. The particulate emitters have been growing stronger in each system. Unless fate is laughing at us, the particulate must be communicating across systems. If so, then our theories about the particulate must be correct, and if these theories are correct, then the Galactic Corporation, House of Braxis, and the ruling board have all kept a terrible secret for far too long. End data. That's all I can access. Privately to Ticon. House of Braxis? They fell decades ago, and there hasn't been a ruling board in nearly as long. Whatever secret Ragnall was referring to seems to have remained a secret. Yes, and I wonder if this Ragnall's theory about the particulate matches ours. Who cares about theories? Like, I'm more concerned with, like, realities? Does that make sense? Alright, you've powered that up, so I'm going to send you up here, too, to help him. You're still miring all this, and that's fine. That is fine. I'm not going to rush you too much. Let's get my guns in here. I'll go ahead and bring these forward. You can see they're making shapes. They're connected together. They act as part of each other, as it were. I'm actually using my lathes for combat right now because I don't have a lot of options. And at this point, they're pretty okay. They're actually fairly useful. I'm going to go ahead and move that up. Move him forward. He's got a missile launcher here, a cannon, two lasers in that beam. He's got two engines, which makes him the fastest ship I have. This guy's got two engines, but because he's so big, I think that makes a difference on how fast he can actually move. Now, we have to clear this out. I'm going to show you a little trick I learned in NAM. I don't know if I suggest this all the time, but if you want to clear out a lot of particulate really fast, this is one way to do it. Just sacrifice a ship. Because again, there's nobody on it. What difference does it make? Right? Right. Right? Right. Let's see if we can claim this energy node. See how we're doing here. We're slowly building on it. This guy's not quite done. Once he gets done with this, I'll move him down there to help. But here's the important part. I can actually get up here and destroy this now. As it was said, this has a lathe. It's going to lathe that thing up right there and destroy it. And my destroyer's rebuilt. Get down here. And let's put you in there, and let's put you in here. And they can both hammer on that guy. We've got... That one's destroyed. We're going to mine all this land. I am more convinced now than ever. Anna, any readings that might lead us to the origin world? None. I hope there would be some remnants, some molecular signatures, anything that would hint at the origin world. If we don't find the origin world, then all this could be for nothing. I remain hopeful, my friends. We've been able to handle the particular threat so far, and better than most, it would seem. We will push onward. Number 9. That music isn't loud or anything. Number 9, though. That's not bad. It's not half bad. All right. There we go. Well, that was missions 2 and 3. So I think I'm going to stop here. I'll see you next episode, where we will begin mission 4. And in the meantime, I'm going to stay here and make sure I do make everything all blue and clean out all this stuff and get rid of all the red. We'll speed up time to make it faster. Why? Because why not? Somebody might come here after me. And wouldn't you want to leave the place better than the way it is that you found it? That's the way I feel. You should always leave someplace better than the way you found it. And with that, I'll see you guys all later. Bye!